Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in the last lecture we have studied that how can we calculate the units for the rate of reaction, and as they are both are based on average rate of reaction and instantaneous rate of reaction. And now we are going to look how can we calculate the units for rate constant for both the first order as well as for the zero order reaction. Okay friends, so as you know that rate constant is, so friends, as you know, rate constant can be defined or can be elaborated in the form of rate law, which is rate is equals to rate constant a raised to x and concentration of b raised to y. When I talk about the first order reaction, in this case the value of x could be 1 and the value of y could be 0, or the value of x could be 0 and the value of y could be 1, so that the value of x plus y should be ultimately 1, then only it would be the first order reaction. For this instance, suppose I am taking y as 0 for making a first order reaction. Suppose I am considering x is equals to 1 and y is equals to 0. Therefore, the overall order of reaction would be x plus y is equals to 1 plus 0, that is 1. So now, when I substitute this value in the above equation, that is rate is equals to k a raised to x and y and b raised to y, then the equation would be b raised to 0. So anything which is raised to 0 is nothing but 1. So therefore I can write this equation as since we have to calculate the unit for rate constant, so therefore I'll keep the rate constant as it is and I'll shift the value of rate to one side. And since we know the unit of rate constant is nothing but moles per dm cube per second, so I'll write it as it is. Per second, and that of the concentration is moles per dm cube. So by this thing the value or the unit of the rate constant is now second inverse. But it is not necessary that the unit for the zero order reaction would also be the same. So how can we calculate that thing? Let us see. Similarly, suppose if I write the equation of the rate law, then I could get rate is equals to k a raised to x and b raised to y. But for zero order reaction, the value of x and the value of y, the both should be 0. Or if I say that the ultimate answer or the sum of x plus y should be 0. So this is only possible in a way when I would take the value of x as 0 and the value of y also as 0. So for zero order reaction, x is equals to 0 as well as y is equals to 0, which means x plus y is also equals to 0. But so substituting this value in the above equation or in the above rate law, then we would get rate is equals to k a raised to 0 and b raised to 0, and as you know any value raised to 0 is nothing but 1. So therefore a raised to 0 will be 1 as well as b raised to 0 will also be 1. So therefore the rate will be is equals to k. But since we have to calculate the unit of rate constant, which is dependent on the rate of reaction as well as which is dependent on the concentration of reactant, so now since we know the k is equals to the rate of reaction and the rate of reaction has a unit of moles per dm cube per second, so this is what the unit of the rate constant for a zero order reaction. So it has been confirmed that the rate constant has different unit based on different order of reaction, which is also based on the concentration of reactants. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know what is rate constant and what are the unit which are dependent on the rate constant depending on the first order and zero order reaction. So thank you so much, and please share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.